Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I will be working on this turkey while that 5D Mark IV camera is going to record my activities.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
All right, so what are we going to do first? First thing we're going to do, this is going to get cooked in stages. Because I'm cooking this turkey a little bit different. I think you're gonna be surprised. But the first thing I need to do is there's two things you can do with a turkey. You can either brine it, which is an overnight job, takes a lot of refrigerator space, or you can inject it. And some people actually do both. In the last video, we made fresh cranberry sauce, so it's right there. Guess what I'm making next after this one? Guess what I'm making? All right, where's my injector? Doctor, please. All right, so what I'm going to do is I made a mixture of butter and garlic and onion. Butter, garlic, onion. I think that's all I put in there. Okay, now I stab it and I watch it plump up and I make tire marks or track marks on this poor little bird. Okay. So the purpose of injecting the turkey is when it winds up being dry, you don't enjoy it all that much. So what you do is you moisten it by putting, instead of rubbing everything all over the outside, where it never does wind up getting down inside. Instead, you use this like hypodermic needle and you suck up the good stuff, which is heated butter, melted butter. And you get it into the meat, which is an unusual way of making a moist bird. And as I'm doing this, I'm watching the meat expand like it's plumping up. Jeez. Very weird. I didn't get it in that one, did I? Okay, so at this point, most people would put it in the oven first and then put it in their pressure cooker. I'm going to try it reverse this time, and we're going to all see how it comes out. So what I'm doing, this is a different pressure cooker. I'll put the link down below. This is an Elite, E-L-I-T-E, and it's a 10-quart, meaning it's quite large. It'll fit the turkey in it very well. Now, my biggest problem is, after it's cooked in here, I need to get it out. So I learned this from Noreen at Noreen's Kitchen. If you haven't seen her and you like cooking stuff, she's a really good one to watch. Her and Nana's Cookery. I love Nana's Cookery also. There's a guy over there that I'm trying to become friends with, but just can't seem to make the connection. His name is Tom, that handles all the stuff because Nana is a grandma, obviously. So now what we're doing is we're making a sling that's going to go in here. And I'm putting three pieces because I want a little extra support. Because I want to put it in the oven after. I don't want it to come out and fall apart. I want it to come out. I want to put it on a cookie sheet. And then after I have it on the cookie sheet, I'm going to put it in the oven, which you can't see. It's off to the side. And I'm going to give it a quick shot to brown it up. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to grab this turkey. Yuck. And I've tested it to make sure it fits in here. I'm going to drop it in. Okay, so now my hands are dirty. Turkey dirty. I hate turkey dirty hands. You guys like turkey dirty hands? So I'm going to wash my hands off because I'm going to have to touch everything to show you. So I'm not going to touch everything with turkey dirty hands. All right, so now what these slings are going to do, I'm going to fold them in over here towards the center. And when I'm ready to take this thing out, I'm going to grab the slings And if I can do it properly, I'm going to pin them all down. Get this one, and 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 this one. And then I'll be able to pull the turkey up. But did this one break? Yeah, this one broke. Well, I did put an extra one in there. So, as long as I can lift it out, I'm doing good. So, yes, I can. I can lift it out. All right, now, because it's a pressure cooker, it must have liquid in there. So what I'm going to use for liquid is probably not something you would use for liquid, but being Peter and doing things a little bit different, I don't normally drink beer because I'm not a drinker, but I got no problem cooking with beer. So it needs to have at least a cup of liquid. So I'm going to put a beer in there. I'm going to add a little peach nectar in there. Give it a little, whatchamacallit, something a little citrusy. So I got a beer in there. And some peach nectar. It looks like I'm way exceeded my 1 cup minimum. Now I'm gonna put this in here. I'm gonna close the top. And I'm gonna cook it for 55 minutes. And after it's been cooked for 55 minutes, I'll set it and stuff in a second. I'm gonna take it out and I'm gonna put it in the oven for another 20 to 30 minutes. I want it to brown at that point. So I'll be right back. Can't wait, right? I can't wait either because I've usually done it the other way around. So this time we're testing. Both of us together, we're testing. Okay, and by magic, we have gone an hour and a few minutes. This is on natural release, meaning I don't have to manually release it, but I should, just to make sure, right? And there we have. We have a pressure cooker chicken. Now remember, you and me, we're doing a trial here because according to Noreen at Noreen's Kitchen, I'm supposed to do this part last and first brown the turkey in the oven. But I did that once before and the turkey is a little soggy. So now, ooh, look at the steam. You want to see what that looks like? I can accommodate you. I can take a picture of the turkey in the pressure cooker. There we go. And if I did a good job, you'll be able to see the picture. All right, now, how am I gonna get this turkey out of here and into this pan? How? Okay, you know how I'm gonna do it? I'm gonna use these bands that I made. Just put them all together and lift. Try to drain as much of the water out as I can. But remember, that's beer. Put it in here. Open it up. And voila, I have a turkey. Amazing! It's a wonderful looking turkey. Now, you know what? I'm not even going to bother to try to take these things out. I'm just going to roll them up and put them down into the pan. Because if I try to take them out now, I know I'm going to wind up screwing it up. Just give the turkey as much room as it can. All right, what am I going to do next? I need a browning agent. I want it to caramelize the skin quickly. I can hear you guys talking, but I can't understand what you're saying. So one of you has the right answer, but it's going to be too late. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to brush it with water. Although I did see somebody brush it with orange juice. I'm going to brush it with butter. It's the safest thing I know to do, is to brush it with butter. So I'm gonna get some butter. Gonna put it up on top here. Gonna get my brush out of the hot water. I was feeling a little bit bold. I think I would brush it with butter and maple syrup, because I got a thing for maple syrup lately. I don't know what my problem is. So I'm going to put more butter on here. Maybe this is the best way to do it. Because what I really want to do is I want this turkey to be golden brown or some facsimile of that. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? So I'm basting it in butter. So I'm rambling now. I'm assuming I'm going to cut some of this stuff out when I do my editing. And if not, you poor guys, you got stuck with Peter's editing job again. Well, it's definitely dripping with butter. It's definitely dripping with butter. Butter! Okay. Now, all I want is I want you to get golden brown. You think you can do it, like, in 20 minutes? We'll find out. Okay, right now the pan is not hot, okay, because it's not in the oven. I put the oven up at 480 degrees because I want to flash color it. I'm not trying to cook it. This puppy is cooked. This turkey, not a puppy, it's a turkey, is cooked. So let's put that in for 20 minutes. It's magic. I'm back. Okay, here's the moment of truth. Did I succeed or not? Let's get this thing out of the oven and onto the counter. Oh, here we go. Wow. Gotta admit, that does look pretty good, doesn't it? Yes, it surely does. Let's take a picture of it so I can put it up online for you. Okay, here's a picture of the turkey from this angle. Here's a picture of the turkey from this angle. I'm going to put the link to the Elite pressure cooker on page 5 down below. Let's see, can I get one from this angle? Yep, get one from that angle. Now, if this tastes as good as it looks, you know something? It ain't half bad to do it in reverse. Cook it in the pressure cooker first, and then cook it in the oven. I cooked it in the oven for 15 minutes. And let's see what happens when I cut it. Are we juicy or are we not juicy? Okay, let's cut a piece off. Go through like that. Cut it out. And press in. Yep, there's juice running out. I'm not going to eat this now because it's really hot. Okay, but I would say this is successful. So there we got. We got turkey that is pressure cooked and then golden browned in the oven. I'll put a link to this in page 5 below. So Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, that's the turkey for this year, guys. Thank you for sticking with me. The links to the camera equipment, the 10-quart pressure cooker on page 5 down below. You guys have a great Thanksgiving. You want to make this for Christmas or any other time of the year. I'm probably going to make a chicken using the same procedures, and we'll see how that comes out. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
Okay, that pot is very hot, so I can't let him get close to it. Not even halfway close to it. That's a turkey. You remember him running around in the backyard? Well, now he's cooked and stuffed. So if you don't behave yourself, you want me to cook you and stuff you? No? Well, that pan is hot. It's radiating the heat. So, but I know you guys wanted to see Jingle Bells. I might put the video up of me giving him a bath and drying him. So you'll get an extra video that's got nothing to do with cameras. So there we go. We got our turkey. You want to get close to it? No, we're not going to do anything dangerous because we want no accidents. at Thanksgiving, right? Okay, what a good boy. Yeah, you are my good boy. All right, guys, bye. Happy Thanksgiving.